Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is the 16th of June 2010, and I'm talking with Martin Higginson, CEO of NetPlayTV, listed on the AIM market, media sector, stock ticker NPT, share price 22.25 pence, market cap 43.41 million pounds sterling, web address netplaytv.plc.uk. Martin, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
You're welcome.
In 2009, Ofcom permitted UK terrestrial TV channels to broadcast between midnight and 6 a.m. and reclassified all transactional gaming as teleshopping. How was this an opportunity for NetPlayTV?
The change in regulation brought a unique moment in time for NetPlayTV. It allowed gaming to be classed as teleshopping, and therefore that delivered us a massive opportunity. We had to change the way we did business, but we then engaged with Channel 5 and ITV to seize on that opportunity and start building our interactive gaming solution through terrestrial channels.
What is NetPlayTV's business model, and what distinguishes NetPlayTV from its peers?
NetPlayTV doesn't really have many peers. We've carved ourselves out a very interesting position. We are an interactive gaming company. Our aim is, as we develop mobile applications, is to deliver everything from instant gratification games, whether you use premium rate billing on your mobile phone or credit cards. So the business model is very, very simple. It is interactive gaming to the masses.
Why are TV companies such as Virgin Media Television, Channel 5 and ITV1 choosing to do business with a tiddler like NetPlayTV?
I think it's an interesting question. NetPlayTV is a unique company that is building and developing a unique proposition. It's fully regulated. It offers a complete end-to-end solution to all these broadcasters. And more importantly, it offers them revenue in what is a declining revenue market.
Why do you believe that more and more countries will begin to regulate gaming? And what do you believe this could mean for NetPlayTV?
We believe ultimately regulation is good. And the reason it's good is that if you look back at the call TV business, that was a hugely profitable business for many, many media companies around the world, but it wasn't regulated. And in not being regulated, it brought with it all of the problems and all of the hassles that we saw over the last sort of 12 to 18 months. And people like ITV lost a revenue stream of about £25 million of profit per annum. So regulation, in our view, is good. It allows you to understand who the user is. It allows you to age verify every single player. We can then interact with the players. If we see them spending too much, we can interact with them and we can curtail their spending habits. So it really allows us to control what our players are doing and monitor them for their own good and safety, which is a big tick in the box from people like Gamcare. It also ultimately provides tax for governments. So I think on a global basis, and certainly probably starting off on a European basis, I think you will see more and more regulation in this market. And with regulation will come more and more broadcasters wanting to do business with the likes of NetPlayTV.
Broadcasters' revenues from traditional advertising markets are shrinking. Does this trend represent an opportunity for NetPlayTV?
Yeah, I think this represents a huge opportunity for companies like NetPlayTV. Broadcasters have historically been one-trick ponies. Their only source of revenue has been advertising. They have tried over the last few years to broaden their income streams. And, you know, as I touched on before, call TV has been one of those income streams that they've looked at. Regulation has forced them to drop that business model, and the need for profit has forced them to look for alternate solutions. What we offer is a solid alternate solution. It is a profitable alternative solution with a long tail. You know, you can get people in using our games via instant gratification using the mobile, and ultimately they can then take that, they can then play on the internet, they continue to play on their mobile, or they can play live games, whether it be via the internet or via the TV channel. It's a complete one-stop solution for broadcasters.
How important to the future of the company is the full launch of the mobile gaming application that will allow TV viewers to use their mobile phones to play transactional games via Bingo Stars and Roulette Nation, etc.?
As you probably know, my background previous to NetPlayTV was very much involved in the mobile. I mean, I built one of the biggest mobile businesses in the world. So we know and understand what mobile users want. We firmly believe that instant gratification is a big tick in the box in the developed world, so markets such as the UK. When we're partnering up with the likes of ITV1, if you're sat at home on your sofa, you don't necessarily want to get up and go and log on to your computer. But what you do have is if you have your mobile phone with you at hand, it means you can just simply text a keyword to one of our short codes and you're in the game. So very much instant gratification. Then if you start looking at this beyond the European shores, start thinking about markets such as India, such as Latin America, Africa, where there is very, very little internet penetration and unlikely to be huge internet penetration for many, many years to come, then the mobile becomes much more of a pivotal device in terms of how are you going to interact with these customers. And if you then start looking at businesses such as Vodafone or Orange on a global basis, I believe that these companies will change. They will become giant banks. They won't become media companies. What they do well is billing and collecting. So the mobile is going to be absolutely pivotal to the success of interactive gaming on an international basis, and certainly in the developing territories where you've got maximum amount of people, least amount of TV channels. So the biggest opportunity for us.
What are your plans for the supercasino.com and challengejackpot.com brands, Martin?
Our plans for all our brands are very simple, and that is to create irresistible brands that ultimately create loyalty beyond reason. And what I mean by that is that people associate with our brand, they start building trust. If we look at Super Casino, Super Casino is very much an aspirational brand. Over the coming weeks and months, we will change the dynamics of what we output on shows like Five. It will become higher end. We'll start doing more and more tournaments. We'll start doing more of a magazine type show and making the whole interaction much more aspirational for the user. We want people to feel that they belong to the Super Casino Club. And the more we can do that, and the more we'll build the loyalty and an irresistible brand. With regards to Challenge Jackpot is a very, very broad church. It is all about snacking, and it's all about snacking interactive games. No matter where you are, whether you're on the bus or whether you're at your PC, it gives you instant gratification games. So whether that be a quick game of bingo, quick game of keno, quick game of slots, spin of a roulette wheel, maybe even a pub quiz, all of those things will be contained in Challenge Jackpot. So a much broader church, fairly equally split, male-female, and a much broader space in terms of the genre.
You closed the company's fixed line premium rate telephony business in 2009. However, you reported and continue to report increased gaming revenue. What can you tell investors about NetPlayTV's financial situation going forward?
I think firstly, closing the fixed line premium rate telephony business was the right thing to do. It allows us to focus on our core business model and allows us to start building on that. We cannot sell into broadcasters something that they no longer do. It was a highly profitable area of our business, but was very opportunistic. What we're now migrating towards is a much more robust business model. The change in regulations middle of last year brought about a whole new set of opportunities with terrestrial broadcasters. We are deeply involved with those broadcasters. We continue to perfect our business model, and we continue to learn and learn fast. And I think what is important in this business and any business is when you spot something that you learn about the mistakes and you fix those mistakes very quickly. And that's what we're doing. So as we look out to the future, I think we're in a very, very interesting space. If you look at the macro, my view is we're absolutely right on the money. The world is going to change. It is going to have more of a reliance on the mobile phone. Instant gaming or interactive gaming is going to become more and more important for broadcasters on a global basis as revenues continue to fall from advertising. So I think NetPlayTV is very well positioned. I think it is uniquely positioned where it is today. We're not going to get everything right, but I think over the coming years, we are very well positioned to build ourselves a solid interactive gaming media business.
What can investors expect from NetPlayTV over the next 12 to 18 months, Martin?
I think over the next 12 to 18 months, they can expect us to be testing a lot of different things with broadcasters, a lot of different things with the likes of ITV1 and Channel 5. As I said before, it is about learning fast and fixing fast. We are perfecting our model. As soon as we perfect that model in the UK, we will start to then roll it out internationally. So I think over the next 12 to 18 months, I'd like to see that we have opened up a number of other territories outside of the UK, and we are starting to really maximise and reap the rewards from our investment, and a heavy investment in both skill sets and knowledge with broadcasters in the UK.
Who are Playtech, and how important is your partnership with Playtech, Martin?
Playtech are very important to us. We signed a 5-year partnership agreement with them, so we're not going to enter into a 5-year partnership lightly. So they are very, very important. They are the largest gaming sort of technology engine in the world. We are working with them in partnership on a number of sort of joint initiatives, such as the mobile application. That is something that we've jointly delivered. As with any partnership, there are always challenges, but what we have delivered is something that is unique, and I'm very proud of our partnership, and we expect that just to get better and better as time goes on. Playtech's a £1 billion company, and I can see them growing further. They will become much stronger in this space, and we couldn't have a better partner.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.